guys, welcome back. Thanks for joining us tonight. Make sure you have your textbook, pencil, scratch paper, and any worksheet that I might have given you for this lesson. If you haven't done that, go ahead and pause the video right now. Okay, welcome back. Today's lesson 3-3, we are multiplying decimals by whole numbers. I'm gonna jump right into the Got It so we can get started because it's just multiplication. There's a couple things I wanna talk to you about estimating to check for reasonableness, so let's get into it. Got It A is 5 times 0.25. We're going to practice like we did last night. We're going to round any partial numbers to a whole number. And I'm gonna explain why in a moment, but let's go ahead and do that first step. So this one stays the same. I'm gonna round this. When I talked to you last night about looking at the digit to the right, it was because we only had it to the first digit past the decimal in the tenths place. But tonight we have it in the hundreds place. I still, because what we're trying to do is round to the nearest whole number, the digit immediately to the right of what you're looking at is the one you're going to consider. If I look at that digit, it is a 2 and it's below 5. And when I talked to you yesterday about rounding, if it's 5 or above, you're going to bump that number up. If it's below a 5, you leave this number the same. Now, it may seem a little strange, but I'm going to explain why it will make sense. 5 times 0, we know, is 0. I'm going to take this estimation of product estimation, and we're going to pin it over here. And I'm just going to put it over here to remember for later. Kind of looks like a little flower. Erase, 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 erase. I'm going to do something else just to show you why that number is going to make sense. If I decided it was too strange, if it didn't make sense rounding it to a 0, let's just put it to the next whole number, which would be a 1. Let's see what happens to my product estimation when I do that. If I multiply 5 times 1, I get a 5. Wow, those two numbers are so different. Let's see how that's going to help us or hurt us. I'm going to put that one over here as well. I'm going to put a little starburst. Ah! Erase, 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 and now I'm going to do the actual calculation. Remember when we are multiplying, decimals don't matter until the answer. You do not need to line decimals up like you do with addition and subtraction. So when you do multiplication, don't worry about those decimals yet, okay? I would recommend stacking the longest number on the top. Doesn't mean it's the largest number, it's just the widest or longest number. So set your problem up like this. Put your 5 down all the way to the right, and then just do your multiplication. 5 times 5 is 25, put that 2 up there, 2 times 5 is 10, and the 2 gives me a 12. 0 times 5 is 0, and the 1 there. The one thing I have to remember, always, always, when you're multiplying, you still have to consider that decimal. Because we are not adding and subtracting, it's not a matter of just pulling it straight down. It may end up there, but it isn't the correct way to do it. Look at the number with the decimal, go all the way to the right, and start counting how many spaces it goes. 1, 2. I'm gonna put this here as a little reminder so we don't forget. This one doesn't have a decimal I have to worry about, so just come on down to your answer. Start at the right. Count over the same number that you did before and put your decimal in. I'm going to put this here. Yes, I went over 2, 2, check, it's done. This is where the estimation comes in handy. The reason for estimating your answers ahead of time and then doing the calculation, it's a really good tool to use to see if your answer is correct, okay? Let's look at our two estimations. This one, remember, we did when we rounded this to a 0. This one, if you'll remember, when we rounded that to a 1. Which one of those two numbers seems the closest or seems the most reasonable when we look at our answer? Now, I know the answer is correct because I did the multiplication and it's also in my teacher book, and you know those are always correct. Not really. Which one of those do you think makes the most sense? If you look at the 0, actually that one is much closer to our actual answer. And if we use that as a gauge, to kind of check to see, does that sound like a reasonable answer? I would say yes. If we use the 5, however, it's so far off, I would question whether or not I did my computation correctly. So please don't be concerned too much with your estimation, because it is just an approximation of what the actual answer is. But this is why using this tool helps us to see if our answer is correct. That was your got it A. I'm gonna check that off my list. I'm gonna have you work on got it F with me. So pause the video, do got it F on your own, and then come back when you're ready and we'll check our answers together. All right, great, how'd you do? Well, look at my board. I went ahead and I went through all the steps, and I'm gonna explain what I did first. Okay, I did do my estimation guessing work first. So I took my decimal problem, I mean a decimal factor, and I rounded it to, yes, because it's below 5, I rounded it to 0. So here's 0 times 11 would give me 0. I put the pin in it over here just so I wouldn't forget what my check for reasonableness estimation is for later. But just in case some of you are still feeling really strange about rounding something to 0, I did round that to a 1, because you said, Mrs. Zimmerman, you said round it to the next whole number, so that would give you a 1. 1 times 11 would give me an 11. Wow, that's a big difference. Let's see how it impacts our answer. So now we're going to go through and do the math. Now I wanted you to do this got it because some of you might be a little rusty with multiplication, and especially when we have to go multiple layers in our multiplication. So let's do it step by step. Follow with me, check your answers, and let's see how you did. So I'm going to start in this place value, the very first place value on the right, and multiply all these digits by that 1. 5 times 1 gives me 5. 4 times 1, 0 times 1, 0 times 1, and that's the first level, a first layer. Now, I'm going to go down to the next layer. But please, please, please notice I need to move over to the left because now I'm in the tens place. I'm in this column. I don't want to put that answer over here because that won't be correct. So please, can everybody say annex the 0? You're going to put a 0 placeholder there so that when you do your addition, it won't mess up and won't give you the incorrect answer. So placeholder, then again, 5 times 1, 4 times 1, 0 times 1, 0 times 1. All my multiplication is finished. See how beautifully lined up all of these columns are? I see so many calculation errors in this step. Beautiful multiplication is done, and then sometimes if you don't line them up properly, we can get confused what we're adding together, which number goes with which column. So please be mindful and be nice and neat so that when you get to this step, you don't make any errors. So we're just gonna add. We had that annex 0, it doesn't change the value, just as a placeholder. 5 plus 0 is 5, 4 plus 5 is 9, 4, 0, 0. I'm not finished. Remember where I said the decimals don't matter until the end? Now is the time we really need to pay attention. Let's go back up to the factors in our multiplication problem. This is the only one that showed any decimal places to the right. So I'm going to count just like we would with the, like we did with the other one, 1, 2, and 3. And yes, I'm going to put that 3 there just as a reminder, because sometimes we have multiple numbers, so I want to know how many to account for. There's 3 in this number. None in here that I need to worry about. So all the way down on my answer, I'm going to count 3 places over, plop that decimal in, do my little check. Yes, I counted all my decimal places, and here's my answer. Okay, what is that actually? 495 thousandths. Is that a whole number yet? It's not. It's still not even half of a whole number. It's almost there, but not quite. But it's still not a whole number. So this is where our estimation in our essential question, how does estimating help us? It helps us to check our answer sometimes. Here's your answer. Here's the actual multiplication. You did a great job. You remembered to annex. You remembered to move over. You did a great job, but is it correct? Let's check for reasonableness. Remember the numbers that we pinned over here on the side? This was when we rounded that to a 0. This was when we rounded that to a 1. Look at the difference. Which one of those estimations do you think really is useful for checking for reasonableness? Yeah, that 0 is much closer to this than that 11 ever was going to be. So we know, once again, we're just going to erase that. We know that that's a much better estimation to check for reasonableness, and that's all that's for. There's your answer. We just finished got it F. I I want you to finish the rest of your goddess, B, C, D, and E. Make sure that you show all your work. Make sure to annex any zeros in that you need to. Make sure to count over those decimals and show that you did your estimation and check for reasonableness. And I'll see you tomorrow.